When the curtain skimmed down on this year's Jazz and Arts Festival, there were mixed reviews, but thousands of patrons felt that the event was worth attending and came out in their numbers to support it. However, former Executive Vice President of the St. Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association, Michael Andrew, says it's now time to tactically review the festival.
I'm sure with a tight economic situation, there would be always justified reasons for being more austere. But I think we need to be a little more efficient as well. And what I mean by that is perhaps it's just about time for us to tactically look at the Jazz Festival, the production, who underwrites it, whether we need to have more private sector players involved, and I think as well the lineup needs to be considered.
This was the second year of the rebranded St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival. The event's budget was significantly reduced. Mr. Andrew believes that a lot more can be done.
I think it's really a question of quality as opposed to quantity. Certainly on the Sunday, it has always been a very nice atmosphere. I think the vast majority of people come here because they come for the atmosphere. The music may be just incidental, it may be secondary. So I always believe that we should just have one headliner and just have fringe activities to keep people going until that headliner comes. But that's my personal opinion.
Tourism Minister Lon Theophilus had expressed that after 2 years of a rebranded Jazz and Arts Festival, there needs to be serious and critical analysis. The St. Lucia Tourist Board is currently conducting its post-mortem of the festival. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.